Hey there, BKFK listeners. We have a super exciting invitation just for you. Want to peek behind the curtain of all the fun we create? Head over to our website and sign up for our awesome newsletter. You'll get the scoop on behind-the-scenes facts, the latest BKFK news, and details about our upcoming stories. You'll also get to meet our amazing performers in our BKFK Hall of Fame. Plus, we've got some cool giveaways lined up just for you. To kick things off, we're giving away a free copy of our audiobook, The House at Pooh Corner, to all new subscribers. That's right, the whole book. So don't miss out. Zoom on over to buykidsforkids.co. Sign up and join the fun with the BKFK family. Hello, dearest BKFK listeners. Coming up in this episode, Yasashi Oni visits the Snaggletonians in Magimajura and is disappointed by the amount of waste in the village.
It's not just unsightly, it's a breeding ground for disease and decay. How can such mighty monsters let their surroundings fall to such a state?
She gives them a magical ring of renewal, which inspires them to think of new ways to reuse and reduce their mess.
I can compact the waste into bricks with my bellowing belly slap, making bricks that we can build things with.
The ring of renewal appeared to grow a little brighter.
But first, let's hear who the superstars are in this episode.
My name is Nicholas. I'm from D.C. I'm 8 years old, and my favorite color is yellow. I like playing soccer. I like Legos and video games.
My name is Amara. I'm 5. My favorite color is red, and my favorite animal is a dragon.
Hi, my name is Omer. I'm 10 years old, and I live in Houston, Texas, and I love video games and sports.
Hi, my name's Aurelia. I'm from Italy and I live in Dubai. I'm 14 years old and I hope you enjoyed this reading.
My name is Nora and I'm 6 years old and I like to play outside. I'm from the USA.
Hi, my name's Giacomo and I'm 12 years old. I'm from Italy and England and I really like cooking.
Hello, my name is Elliot. And I love to play with my baby brother, and I like to listen to Bike at 4 Kids. And I'm 7 years old.
Well done, guys. What a star-studded cast. Remember, listeners, if you'd like to perform with us, just go to buykids4kids.co and click on Audition. Okay, Ruby, let's get on with the story.
Turning trash into treasure. One fine morning in the mystical land of Magimajura, Lexi Lightdancer, the ninja pixie, decided to invite his old master, Yasashi Oni, to visit the village. Yasashi Oni had taught Lexi the wise and ancient ninja ways on the Moonshadow Mountains. Lexi missed her master and decided to return to the Moonshadow Mountains to invite Yasashi Oni for a visit to the village. Bursting with pride, Lexi zipped through the magical forests and up the steep trails of the Moonshadow Mountains to reach Yasashi's home.
Master Oni!
Lexi called out as he approached, his voice echoing through the silent mountain air.
I've come to invite you to visit our beautiful village. It's even more magical than before.
Yasashi Oni, meditating peacefully, opened her eyes and smiled at her former pupil.
My dear Lexi,
she replied, her voice as calm as the mountain breeze.
How good it is to see you again. It would be my pleasure. Let's see how Magimajura has grown.
Together they descended into the village. Lexi held Yasashi's hand and guided her around, pointing as they walked. all manner of creatures came out to welcome the new visitor. Goblins, brownies, trolls, centaurs, minotaurs, hippogriffs, and more. However, as they walked through the village, Yasashi Oni's keen eye noticed something wrong. Despite the enchantment and laughter, piles of stinking, rotting trash lay scattered around.
Lexi, observe.
Yasashi Oni began as they approached the cave shared by Grumblegut the ogre, Snotbeard the giant, and Troller the troll.
This clutter of old bones, rotten food scraps, and broken containers. It's not just unsightly, it's a breeding ground for disease and decay. How can such mighty monsters let their surroundings fall to such a state?
Grumblegut, his face reddening under his gnarled, bark-like skin, shuffled his feet uncomfortably.
I suppose I've been a little bit lazy, man. I didn't think it was all that bad.
And here, Troller.
Yasashi Oni remarked, her voice laced with disappointment.
The layers of slimy tissues and discarded slime bottles outside the cave do more than just smell. They harm the earth itself. Is this the mark you choose to leave on the land?
Troller sniffed and hung her head.
I got caught up in my sneezing and forgot about the mess.
Snotbeard tried to stand in front of a huge pile of boulders and shards of rock that littered the ground alongside spilled oils and broken tools.
Snotbeard,
Yasashi Oni said, looking up at the towering figure.
What a waste! Just look at what you've thrown away. There is so much you can do with this. Why throw it away?
Snotbeard blushed.
You're right, Yasashi Oni. I should be more careful. I can do better.
Led by Lexi, Yasashi walked on through the village. Outside Silvaris the Elf's beautifully vibrant home, Yasashi Oni paused once again.
Silvaris, the dyes and paints you discard carelessly dirty the streams and soil. Your skills in craft brings beauty, but should not bring harm.
Silvaris's eyes widened in shock. Before she could reply, the Oni had walked on. She passed the burrow of Snickerfang and Jinx. It was a catastrophe. It was cluttered with old gadgets, torn clothes, and broken trinkets. Yasashi Oni faced Snickerfang and Jinx.
Such clever beings shouldn't live amongst chaos. Your home should be a reflection of your ingenious spirits, not a scrap heap.
Both goblins, looking around as if seeing their surroundings for the first time, nodded sheepishly. Yasashi looked sternly at Lexi.
Little pixie ninja, this is a sad state of affairs. You cannot sit by and just let this happen. Action is needed.
What should I do? Master Yasashi?
Asked Lexi.
This is a problem caused by everyone,
said Yasashi.
And it affects everyone. Therefore, everyone needs to help to fix this problem.
Lexi thought for a moment and then said,
I'll call for a monster moot.
A monster moot?
Asked Yasashi.
That is when we all gather at the Glugging Gargoyle to discuss important issues. Leave this to me.
His little legs were a spinning blur as he raced around the village, shouting,
Monster moot! Monster moot!
Soon enough, all the Magimajurans had all noisily gathered at the Glugging Gargoyle. Lexi banged the gong of the gargoyle, the signal for silence.
Thank you all for coming to the Monster Moot. I'd like to welcome our honored visitor, Yasashi Oni.
Everyone politely applauded.
Thank you, Lexi,
said Yasashi.
I'm sure you all have some idea of why you are here.
The Magimajurans coughed nervously and shuffled around.
Magimajura has been neglected. Your streets are filthy. Your homes are a disgrace. You not only need to clean up, but you need to prevent more waste in the future.
But how?
Came a little voice from the crowd. Yasashi smiled and waved her hand in the air in the shape of a circle. As she did so, a shimmering, colorless shape floated in the air.
This is the Ring of Renewal. See how gray it is? You can change this. Think of ways which you can do something about this. We don't want less waste. We want zero waste.
The Magimajurans shrugged and looked around at each other. Grumblegut was the first to offer a solution.
I can compact the waste into bricks with my bellowing belly slap, making bricks that we can build things with.
The Ring of Renewal appeared to grow a little brighter. Silvaris added,
I'll create baskets made from enchanted vines to hold our food scraps. They'll decompose and turn into compost, and we can grow more food with it.
Great idea,
cried Troller.
And I'll sneeze on them to make them rot faster.
The ring sparkled a bit more with a slight purple glimmer. Snickerfang suggested,
we can use our illusions to make recycling bins look like magical chests. It could make throwing things away fun and make sure everything is sorted properly.
The ring swelled, now with a little glowing green and yellow.
That is a sparkling idea,
said Granny Gigglesnort.
Let's take all those old potion bottles and turn them to twinkling lights for our gardens. I can show everyone how to fill them with the glimmering spell so they light up at night.
I will set up a gadget fix-it workshop,
said Sparky.
We can all bring broken tools and toys. I'll fix them. In fact, I can make them even better than what they were.
I will gather discarded metal pieces from old battles and adventures,
said Sir Chuckle Nugget.
I'll melt them down in my castle forge, and with the help of my Mini-Mai battalion, we'll make them into decorative armor for my castle ducks.
The glugging gargoyle buzzed with excitement as each creature suggested a creative idea. Yasashi Oni nodded, pleased.
Excellent idea! You have learned to reduce, reuse, and re-enchant things instead of discarding them. You can turn old things into useful magical tools or charming artifacts.
By this time, the ring was brightly pulsing and glowing with every color in the rainbow.
The Ring of Renewal is happy. I will leave the ring here for you as a reminder that it isn't just about being tidy. It's about respect. Respect for our home, for each other, and for the generations to come.
And so began the grand transformation. The Magimajurans bustled around, fixing, recycling, and reusing. Soon, they didn't even think about it. They just did it without thinking. And from that day on, they were proud of their creativity, proud of their village, and proud of their Ring of Renewal.
Anyone for a quiz? Why not? Question one. Who did Lexi invite to visit the village of Snaggleton? A. Grumblegut the Ogre. B. Yasashi Oni. C. Granny Gigglesnort. Or D. Silvaris the Elf. And the answer is B, Yasashi Oni. Question 2. Where did Lexi learn the ancient ninja ways? A, the Glugin Gargoyle. B, the Moonshadow Mountains. C, the village of Snaggleton. Or D, the whimsical Whispering Woods. And the answer is B, the Moonshadow Mountains. Question 3. What problem did Yasashi Oni notice in the village? A, too many parties. B, piles of trash everywhere. C, not enough food. Or D, too many noisy monsters. And the answer is B, piles of trash everywhere. Although you would be forgiven for having guessed D, because the monsters certainly were noisy. Question 4. Who lived in the cave with Grumblegut? A, Snotbeard and Troller. B, Lexi and Silvarus. C, Snickerfang and Jinx. Or D, Sir Chuckle-Nugget and Granny. And the answer is A. Grumblegut's cavemates are Snotbeard and Troller. Question 5. What idea did Grumblegut suggest to help with the trash? A, planting trees. B, building with compacted waste bricks. C, using magic to disappear trash. Or D, singing songs about cleanliness. And the answer is B, building with compacted waste bricks. Hey guys, if you like this episode, please share it with your friends and family. It is one of the best ways to support BKFK Storytime.